This week on the Hoover Boys.
Light in here is terrible. Well, everyone is here at the house, and they almost brought all their things they dug out of the ground in 2018.
I tried to bring some stuff from last year, too.
Yeah. We brought a 2 reals from last year. I'm like, that's not from this year. Today, no digging. We're going to go over, I guess, our best finds of the year and all of our other finds that we got to keep our hands on. Who wants to go first?
Yeah,
no,
it's
Green
Tea. Leo? You can do me, because I have like 4,000.
I can do you?
Leo.
Here, somebody take the camera. Yeah. I got to do it, or are you going to tell me what you have here?
We're already PG-13.
You got a couple bottles?
Yep, it's bag seals.
Bag seals from the bag seal farm. We all have tons of those.
Mm-hmm.
Your Civil War dig?
Mm-hmm.
Just go detecting. You got a couple coppers. King George II. Matron, some buttons, any military buttons?
No.
No, this is from the just go detecting dig.
Yeah, half of those finds were made without
1837 No Stars seated Liberty Dime.
I said you could take full tabs at home,
yeah. No!
No way!
What is that, Undine?
It's beautiful.
It's seated.
You think?
I didn't even flip it over
it's
yet.
Seated. It is. It's the old seated, dude.
I can tell from up here.
Good job, buddy. That could be a Civil War seated. Ever?
First seated ever.
Get out of here. One Indian.
Yep.
Had that flashlight, Brad.
And you got huge cut piece of Spanish silver. Cut 8 reals. One bit. That's an early one, too. That's a beautiful coin. What's your favorite find of the year, Leo?
Oh, man. I'm gonna say the cut.
Bob's the cut?
I'm gonna go with the cut.
I don't blame you there. That's a good piece of Spanish.
What?
Who's next?
You know you're going that way.
I'm going this way?
Well,
that's right. I guess you didn't get out that much this year either. You're a working man now. You got out more than Leo, though, apparently.
Two times more than Leo.
Well, he brought half his stuff from 2016.
You got here? Some shoe buckle frame.
It's quality over quantity.
Some bag seals and some musket balls and Civil War bullets.
Shh, Kurt's trying to film.
This was off the last episode of the year, and that ends up being circa 1675 sword. What is it called? Like a
handguard.
Well, like the sword would come up this way. That's incredible. That site was really early. We need to get back there, hopefully. All his little pieces and stuff. His nurse's badge. You said it's Civil War era?
Yeah, was probably up with 10.
Couple clay marbles. Some early buttons, tombacks. Anything you want to highlight over on your paper tail?
That's
an early
a really
buckle.
Old buckle.
Yeah, that's 16s probably.
I think that's part of
it's a
heel plate.
Heel
with
plate,
the star
absolutely.
In the middle.
That's an interesting little thing.
That's an interesting little decorative thing.
Little buckley strap thing adjuster.
That's exactly what it is. It's a couple awesome clay marbles.
Yeah, I mentioned those. This is your just go detecting stuff. Oh no, we got the reflection from the light and everything. Yeah, it's bad. We gotta take the glass off everything. We laid out some of your coins from the year. Some beautiful buffalo nickel. I think that was the saltwater beach. Got a couple shield nickels.
Oh, it's a shield
nickel. A few mercs. Bunch of little Indian head scents. Some tokens. Is this the birch scent?
That is my birch scent.
You got the birch scent.
I found that in New England, remember?
Yeah. He cut into a birch tree and carved the 1C. A couple native points, arrowheads. Got some modern rosy silver. How many coppers? Did you count your coppers?
All of them? No.
You got some pretty good. Actually, where's my light? Where did my light go? I'll use the bob light. Yeah. Nice half cent there, 1832. Lighting is terrible.
Yeah, yeah.
King George I, King George III, the second. There's a Connecticut copper that's holed right in the middle.
My first two hold coins ever.
No, they're not.
Oh.
I've actually gone back in the episodes and found some ear hold coins.
What?
That's a one real, 1780, I believe. His cob, he live dug a cob this year. Is that a cob?
That's a cob.
Dude, that's a cob.
Is that a cob?
That's a cob.
That's not a cob.
I think that's a cob.
That's a cob.
That's a half real cob.
That's a cob.
Kind of cob I get
you just cobbed.
Porn.
No. We just left like a cob. I told you it sounded like a little silver.
No way.
And his lead pewter USA button.
Yes.
That was out of the unbelievable episode.
That's a dug real authentic
one. Oh, gosh. Yeah. Good job, Bobby.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
I'm going to give my back a little break. You guys won't have to worry about that.
Okay.
This is fake.
It is.
Hey.
Look, that's supposed to say Spain, and it says S-P-A-N.
Why are you playing with his coin?
S-P-A-N. You see?
Right,
it's
you ready?
An I.
Yeah, it's kind of a mess.
It's counterfeiting.
It's okay.
So start with the mess and clean up with the goodness.
And I think
jump right in. Here's the things that Brad wants to share from his year of digging. He just what is going on? And you have so much. You have cannonball fragments up here.
Everything. I don't see.
Look at these, Bill.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Look, we can make you a pair of earrings.
Mm-hmm. It puts mine in the shame.
That's not a lock.
Nice 1850s padlocks, train locks, rail car locks, whatever. Shoe buckle frames
and musket
balls, and just buttons galore. I'd love to know how many buttons we found. Oh, nice.
The scabbard bayonet, too.
Oh, look at this guy just sitting there. That deserves a little case.
I remember finding that. Mm. Nice tomback button.
I got some nickels in
there. Oh, these are Indians in here.
Yeah. Oh, what is that? That's disgusting. Ugh.
What was that?
I don't know. Something.
Indians. You got some nickels. These are buffalo nickels. Or all your nickels.
I got one of those.
I don't know what that is from.
Okay. Oh,
look, you got clad in here.
No,
is that all your clad?
I do have clad.
Just move it on. Just move on.
Watch wine and keys.
Yeah. Memorial.
Get your stuff from the Disco Detecting Civil War.
Look at that right there.
You got George Lesh's.
Who else has a Lesh?
Signature. Predator Tools, baby.
Not that.
Up here?
Oh, yeah.
Do a little flyby of your bag sales from the bag sale farm. I think they're awesome. That place is more to show. Your Bremen bag seal and your Cleveland peas. This is from a mental health day. You want to tell us about this?
Yeah, a little Georgian functional toy cannon.
Yeah.
We don't find those over here too often.
No. That actually came from the site that we filmed episode 200 with our friend John.
Shot something out.
It's optional. You put a little black powder or whatever in there, and it actually would fire.
Take out your best friend.
They find them over in England. Had the nice shark tooth. Nice early button there.
I just had to pull out some buttons.
Oh, absolutely.
Monstrous.
Look at that design. That is wild.
That would definitely be easy to
make. Some native. That was from New England, wasn't it? What is this piece?
Just a pretty piece of material.
That is a pretty piece of material. Flip it over real fast.
Yeah, because it's ugly.
You fly an eagle, colonial cufflinks. That's one of those like trade coin type.
Carry weight.
Yeah. I got a couple of those. Mm. They sound good.
You got one of those?
Yeah, you got another New York copper.
We'll get one this year.
New York half penny. Got one of those last year. Did you count your coppers?
No, I did not.
You did pretty well on the coppers. All our nasty farm field coppers. Nice colonials. Oh, we got a couple of nice Hibernias there. Nice straight bust, large cent and half cent.
Some classic. A
couple
classic.
Others. Yeah. Some greenies.
Those were all 8 feet from one another. It's 1865, 1868, and 1869.
Yeah, that 69 is phenomenal.
Full Libertitis.
Oop, should I go down there yet?
It's whatever.
I guess this is your newer silver over here. You got a couple of Standing Liberty quarters, a Barber dime, some Mercs, some Rosies. Now they're getting older. Is this a seated? Oh, is that your Carson City?
Double C's.
It's your first Carson City coin. Another seated Liberty, a couple reals, half real and a one real.
Well, should we show that yet?
Sure.
Here's some other reals. Oh, you got a trime? When did you get a trime this year?
I don't know, but I boiled it.
Oh, that's right. You got it out of the water. Yeah. It was one of your water digs. That was a water dig. This was the same day. That was in New England. That one real.
Yeah, I found with this about 20 feet from that coin.
Yeah. Stunning half cent. 1829. You got a 2 cent piece?
I got one.
Did everyone get one?
Maybe
Bob?
Me too. I think there's another one.
And Leo, I guess?
Yeah.
Barber Quarter?
I think I have one. It looks like a shield nickel, though.
And it's that was a mental health day. That's a 1918? I didn't know the thing was that old. Here's his colonial half dollar.
And then I flipped it, and it's big.
No!
Yeah, it's big.
Oh, no!
Yeah, I know.
It's really big.
It's really freaking big, man.
Oh, no!
Oh, no.
Oh, no! No! No!
It's really big.
I'm terrified.
I'm terrified too. I'm gonna pick it out here.
French coin. King Louis. The 15th. 1730. That was episode 200.
Seriously?
Yeah. Then his gold coin. Are you okay?
Please come here. Please come here.
No!
Please come here.
No! I tested before you did.
Oh my god.
I owe you $50.
Are you for real?
That's a gold coin.
Real? I think I got one, guys.
Are you freaking kidding me?
I think I got one.
Dude, you have a cut gold
real.
Coin.
I think I got
dude,
one.
Dude, it's so heavy. You did.
That is
you
for
did.
Real.
You did. I guess we'll talk about the gold coin. The 1736. King Louis. Is that the 13th or 14th? Is it, you guys looking for something? Did you lose something?
Yeah, he's a 15th. Something
went flying. Yep, the broken gold coin. Brad got on his first cat bus dime.
Liberty cat, I'm just kidding.
Cat bus dime and a drape bust dime.
Oh my god!
Oh my god!
1798
over 1797. You want to flip over that little cutie?
Yeah, that's the heraldic.
Maybe hit it with some sidelight because yeah, it's just stunning.
This is cozy. Get that.
Get that it's thing.
It's the same eagle.
This heraldic eagle.
This is.
There it is. And the.
Give me a second, Bill.
The George Washington inauguration button.
My find of the year.
This is your favorite find of the year?
Yeah, that's my find of the year.
What is happening? What are you doing?
Oh my god.
What?
It's above the hole, dude.
Oh, here.
Holy
oh.
I'm wrecked.
No!
Oh,
no! No! It's a 13 colony George Washington button. You gotta be kidding me.
Oh, I'm sorry,
awesome.
I couldn't get the words
out. I thought it was gonna be gold. You gotta be kidding me, dude. Is it all there? No, it's a little broken. Yeah.
That's it.
You got some goodies this year, brother.
Thank you.
You got some goodies. What is happening here?
It's a little search party because
they're treasure hunting under the treasure table.
My shirt, like,
there's stuff that we found
on what was paper? Here? I think it was a cufflink.
No, it was the watch winding key.
Hey, Bill,
the watch winding key? All right, well, we'll be back with Billy's stuff. Oh, you got it? Surface fine. All right, let's get right into Billy.
Hey, Brad, you can put that on the table for next year.
What's your favorite find?
What's your favorite find?
You already said the George Washington.
Oh, I thought you said
you forgot to ask Bob.
Yeah, I was going to say you forgot to ask Bob.
Did I?
You did.
What's your favorite find, Bobby? Cobb?
My favorite find.
Real pirate treasure?
I think it's the Birch Scent.
Your Birch Scent?
Well, the Birch Scent. I mean, that's...
It's custom.
That's the carving that they use to create the dye for the birch scent.
All right.
And
well,
my USA pewter button would have to be my favorite find.
Oh, the USA lead pewter?
Yeah.
That's funny because that's going to end up being my favorite find.
Yeah.
All right, Billy.
What's up?
Absolutely, America.
Oh, yeah.
Billy had a great little year. You got a headache?
No, I just hate that coin.
That's just some miscellaneous stuff.
Your miscellaneous stuff?
Yeah.
You got some nice stuff in here. Saddle strap guide. Some old buckles.
Yeah.
Look at the size of this thing.
That's Billy's shoe buckle.
That's huge.
That's a ginormous saddle.
That's what
buckle.
Used to hold my underwear together.
Yeah. A little milk bottle full of buttons.
Yeah.
Did you find this?
Yeah, that's the one we dug with the milk bottle. It's a little
nice.
Creamer. This is from Virginia.
Yeah? Oh. Just go detecting?
Oh, yeah.
Bobby's meatballing your stuff.
He can meatball it.
Billy, you bought a lot of stuff on eBay this year.
What we got going on over here? We got some more
yeah.
Civil War bullets. It's a nice little buckle there. Is it the inside of a bell, like a clapper yes. to the bell or a drawer pull? Something like
sure.
that.
Oh, we're going to say the bell.
Okay.
That looks correct.
St. Christopher pin?
Yeah, it was car badge. The thing next to it was a I think it was World War One.
World War One cross cannons?
Looks WW1 artillery.
What do you got going on over here?
Is that
newer?
That was, I forget the actual, it was a...
That looks Boy Scoutish.
No, it's not Boy Scout, it's an actual club of some sort, but not Boy Scout.
And a knee buckle.
Oh, is that a FOE, Fraternal
yes,
Order of the Eagle?
Eagle button?
Yeah, it's
a FOE.
Is that cross silver?
No.
No?
I don't know. Right off, check.
Oh, you found your marbles, about time. That's cool.
My anvil.
Really early jeweler's anvil or button anvil?
I would say a jeweler's anvil.
Billy found his first crotal bell ever. First complete crotal bell. Yay!
And it dangles.
Some of his shark's teeth from our beach hunt.
Mm-hmm.
He has some nice goodies over here. A little silver cuff link. Merc dime, another silver cuff link. It came out behind the old tavern. Nice early button there. Shield. Is that Excelsior?
No, that's your Eagle. That's the Rebel War button.
Did you find this, Billy?
Yes.
Get that out of here. There's the watch wine and key Brad just found on the ground.
Yeah, first find. First service.
Billy's first 2 cent piece. We went back to back 2 cent pieces in the woods. One of our first hunts of the year. And there's his little half real cufflink looking.
Oh, we forgot to
button.
Look at mine. I have the same one, but a huge...
See, I haven't talked about your coins yet, have I?
No.
These coins. That's a shiny little barber dime.
Yeah, it's because I cleaned it.
Some coppers, some farm field... Oh, yeah, Bobby had one of them, too.
I forgot it was upside down.
No, it was upside down. Too bad the date's busted. I think they're all 1769. That's the coat button. And Billy found the cuff link. Pretty awesome.
That is pretty
cool. There you go, buddy. Billy's coppers...
Oh, it's a whole mix
Toasty farm field coppers. A couple Indians, another copper. Mm. No, here's your... No, that's just King George III. I thought that was something else. Drape bust half cent. That's your Virginia. You got a Virginia half penny.
Yeah.
That thing's toasty. Just like, unfortunately, like the
Actually,
Nova.
If you look at this one.
The Nova Constellation.
The
what are you talking?
On the back of it.
What are you saying?
If you look on the back, you'll see the shield of that one.
Stop yelling.
Other side. Flip it over.
What are you telling me? Oh, yeah, there we go. Well, I can see it. I don't know if it's showing up in the camera very well. There we go, just like that. Yeah, it's a Virginia half penny. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Oh, good. You took the tops off of this. Is this your oldest coin ever?
Yes.
That's the William III?
William III, yes.
There's a beautiful classic head, 1812, large cent. You found both of these in the same hunt.
Mm-hmm.
1794 on both of them, large cent and half cent, Liberty caps.
Even the backs look great.
Yeah, those are some great looking coins. Almost dropped something. And Billy, what's your favorite find of the year?
Oh, well, I'm going to say both of these.
Both of what?
Wow.
Your early...
Better than
the
curse
word. Yeah, it is.
Your early American coppers?
Yes.
Well, they're both stunning, I'll tell you that much.
Yeah, I think they're my favorite.
And Billy left a couple things at home. His first...
1776, the counterfeit. And then it was my first... I keep
on... Standing Liberty Quarter.
Quarter.
You flip it.
Flip it. Ooh.
Oh, it's a Stand of Liberty.
It's my first Stand of Liberty.
Dude, congrats. Stand Liberty Quarter, buddy. Then another silver piece.
Yeah, silver piece.
All right, I'm gonna give my back a break. And we'll be back with the mess on that end of the table.
The Kurt Show will continue.
Yeah.
A fishing swivel, really?
So Bob's going through all my stuff. Like, what is this? What? I think. All right, Bob, watch this episode, and I'll show you everything. Okay.
You're gonna say you found all this stuff.
I did find all that stuff. I went out to my truck this morning and got this coffee can out there. I keep there. We just throw, like, you know, debuckles and things that we're not sure what they are yet. So that's a big, you know, what's it type bucket.
It's a stuffed
Clad, Wheaties.
He's a part-time fireman.
Couple glass things I found. This was actually with the metal detector. I beeped the stopper. Let's jump into this case of stuff. Civil War bullets, lead, buckles, marbles, tokens, whole mess load of shoe buckle frames, broken. Well, this one here's a complete frame. Very popular design, the line design, as you can see. Some other buttons and tobacco tampers or coat hangers, whatever you want to call them. Some of them are coat hangers. Can you please, while I'm trying to work over here?
Bro, you're not supposed to be filming me while I'm tucking my shirt in.
I'm about to get a huge eyeful.
Was I supposed to bring my
These guys are out of control. Bobby's in the other room now. I had to put him in timeout. Here's a buckle from an early property. I didn't get that on video, but that's a, I believe that's a 1600s buckle. Here's all my junk type jewelry. I didn't get anything that was gold in 2018. I got plenty of gold plated stuff. Some other little things. Ox knob. A couple ox knobs. Look at that. Little tiny one. Here's just a plate of random bag seals from the bag seal farm. And just a bunch of buttons that I haven't put away yet. Because this thing's already full of buttons. I mean, as you can see, we dig a ton of buttons. We like buttons. Buttons mean you're on a good site. Dig a lot of thimbles, too. It's a nice early thimble there. There's some of my toasty military buttons and two-piece buttons in here. Actually, that's a War of 1812 button there, but it's toasted. A bunch of other, you know, pieces of things. It looks like the butt off a gun stock. I think that's a trigger guard there. Skeleton keys, spoon bowls. I don't even know where to go next, Billy. I guess I'll do some Civil War stuff. Here's my fall relic hunt of Jisco detecting. Bunch of bullets. Got my first Enfield and some other Confederate bullets in there. Half a Hoskins shell and some.
How about deep?
That is a deep hole. Iron.
I don't know if that's a shell. I think that is a shell,
oh, dude.
That's an artillery shell.
Artillery shell.
And some other shell fragments. Let's do this little guy. This was part to like an 1820s militia belt plate. You can see the town and arrows there and part of the Eagle's wing. Got my first ever breastplate this year.
I just popped up that. It might be a breastplate, dude.
I think it's a breastplate.
Is it a breast? Oh! Oh, my God. Oh! Here, you hold this. This is mine.
I hate you! Holy cow!
That thing's a beauty. Billy.
Yes.
Remember this thing?
The flask? Oh, yeah.
Yeah, the powder flask.
And Thomas was there.
All right, I don't even know where to go now. I guess we'll go in here. A bunch of my river finds are in here. A bunch of my river buttons. See, I told you we found a lot of buttons. More buttons. These little tiny buttons. Some of those are like 20 signals. More buttons out of the river. Crotal bell. I got a crotal bell out of the river. That one's all locked up. Knee buckle. Here's are most of my toasted coppers. I got my nicer coppers in this case from the year. Here's my toasted or smooth river coppers. Big buttons out of the river. I love the river finds. Indians. Definitely didn't find as many Indians last year as I have in years past. Just shows we've been hunting older sites. Those are, I guess, river Indians. Buffalo nickels. There's a shield. Nice complete girdle bell. Some native pieces. Arrowheads. All right, let's get on to the good goods.
Yeah.
The good goods. Is that gonna?
Oh,
yeah. It's gonna. So make sure it's stable. Where's
oh
the?
Oh my God.
It's fine. I don't know where my light went. Let me get my light out. Coppers need the side light. There's a nice ornate open work shoe buckle frame there. That's a War of 1812 British Royal Navy snake buckle piece would be a snake buckle here, another lion's head, early buckle. Some of the Indians, a couple greenies, a couple out of the river. Like, that's a fatty that came out of the river. Same thing with this shield nickel. It came out beautiful.
I even like that shield nickel.
A couple watch winding keys. Look at all these 2 cent pieces, Bob. You see my 2 centers? I got one out of the river. That's really pretty.
To yell at him.
I can't hear a word you're saying with this head cold I have.
I don't want to get punished again. I won't comment on that.
Bunch of the early Tom back buttons, scroll works. Bunch of my U.S. large scents, some of my nicer ones I have out in the case. There's a cut one there that's, I think, really cool. I got out of the water. Straight bust out of the water, 1798. Got my first couple of Liberty caps, 1795. And this one here is one out of the river. Kind of hard to get down to show up. The unbelievable hunt. My best copper day ever, 16 copper coins. There's a Connecticut there. That's a Woods Hibernia, really nice straight bust, couple KG2s and Hibernias and some uglier ones. I got some of my nicest King George II's this year.
It was like 82, 83. Oh, KG2, look at that. Oh, that's my best one ever.
Gosh.
You ready for this?
Holy cow.
Easy. One wiper.
Oh.
Holy crap.
Wow.
Look at this coin. Look at that.
Wow.
Unbelievable. Thank you, fellas. This is the nicest copper I've ever dug.
Good awesome. Job. Nice.
Oh my. 1730 or 1739.
Look at the detail on it.
It's amazing.
Like these here, right here. Those are some beautiful coppers. That one there is out of the river. Nice early colonial copper coins. Got a lot of King George II's. They like me. There's some King George III's. Couple nice Connecticut coppers out of the river, which makes for a grand total of 133 big coppers and a cute little artillery button. I didn't talk about my cufflinks. I just really love the colonial cufflinks.
It would have been amazing if the rocks were still on that.
Yeah, those heads, stones in them, like this one here. There's one with a stone left in it.
Cool stuff. We'll talk about my silvers. Let's talk about this. This came out of the river. Some of my nicer shark's teeth from the year. I got one little small megalodon tooth and the lead pewter smoking pipe. That's a rare find. Left the rocks and stones in there. Silver. Got some nice big shinies this year. Yeah, you got that. Thanks, buddy. I put it in here. My silver, excuse me, and some Native American arrowheads. Some were gifts, some were finds.
This whole case is silver?
Yeah, everything else is silver and stone. Everything's silver and stone.
We'll see about that.
I think I only found one of those. The other two are, I think, a Coinstar finds. Do I have any mercs in here? Did I not find a merc at all last year?
You got three.
Oh, mercs. I got three mercs over here. Okay. Three mercs, nice early colonial spoon.
You bypassed 20th century silver.
I did. That shows how early the sites we were digging. Nice silver cufflink there. Some other silver cufflinks. Nice silver thimble. Ring. Silver pendant. Silver thimble. Any other silver things? There's a silver ring out of the water. Barber dimes. Seated Liberty dimes.
I like how the barber dimes are all one dime.
Oh, yes, you don't see the see what they are. Let's see, there's all my seated dimes. I got two seated half dimes, and I got my first ever seated Liberty half dollar.
Come on, baby. Be seated. All the large cents in here. It's seated, dude. Oh, my God. 1876. I just found a seated Liberty half dollar. Oh, my God.
Got a trime. Haven't trimmed in a while. Didn't trim at all last year.
What a cutie.
My Washington quarters, a couple barber quarters. Had a nice half dollar year. Not first barber half dollar as well. Forgot about that one. 1899.
Got me by a year.
Finally found a Morgan. That was a joy. 1900 Morgan dollar. Dude, it's a silver dollar. There's no way. Oh my God. Did I just get a Morgan? What is this? What is this? I think it's a Morgan, dude. Oh my God. Foreign silvers. Oh, there's a V-nickel down here. How'd that get in there? Did you do that?
I know,
that's definitely something you would do. That's hilarious. Got on 18 Spanish silvers this year. Three of them are cut.
But look at it, though. I mean, phenomenal.
It's not a bad V-nickel. That is the V-nickel that we've been handing off all year long. You son of a... First cut piece of Pistarine, one of my favorite coin designs. Pulled a cob, Spanish cob, out of the river. That's 1737. Actually has a date on there. A bunch of the Spanish were from the river. That was from the river. I actually found this one, and that in the same day. Episode is called Black Silver. Alrighty, what else we got going on in here? I got three cat bust half dimes, 1835, 36, and 37. The 35 and 36 were found on the same day. I popped a cap three times last year. And my oldest silver ever, 1711, cut piece of a two reals, King Charles III, the Pretender. And that thing was minted over in Barcelona. So that's all my silver. I got a 50 cent to Seamies. Yeah, nice silver haul this year.
I'll get this out of here.
Thank you. And two of my best military buttons. First Regiment. This button's like uber rare. USA and E. Artillerist and engineer button. And that leads me to my favorite find of the year. Revolutionary War Continental Army Cast Pewter USA coat button. 1777 to 1782. Full shank, cast seam mold. It's just absolutely perfect. And it was a joy to find. Okay. So let's go out and have a steak dinner. I do. Woo! I'm sweating. That's yeah, tough. Right? It's tougher than you think. It's hard to comprehend that many things came out of the ground this year. Well, until next week, this could be a fun little video that me, Brad, and Bill did. Oh. The other guys don't know anything about it yet, so I'm kind of curious what they think when that video comes out. But until then, help clean up the ground, dig it all, and take your trash with you. Why, buddy?
All holes matter.
Holy Toledo, what do we zoom in on here? The gold coin? Brad's least favorite find of the year?
Yeah.
And way more important than the finds that we made, what I cherish are the friendships that we've gained along the way. And in 2018, we met some awesome people. We made some incredible friendships. And the memories we made together will last forever. I just want to say a huge congratulations to all you guys and gals on your finds. And I cannot wait to do it again in 2019. Good friends, good loyal friends are hard to find these days. So when you find them, it's pretty special. So at the end of last year's episode, I went around and asked everybody what they wanted to find in 2019. And I wanted to pull a copper out of a body of water. That's what I wanted to do. And I did that. And I was very happy about doing that. I did that a lot of times last year. But I didn't find one piece of gold. So my goal for 2019, something that's real gold. Something, anything, a ring, it can be a coin, I don't care. I just want something that's gold.
You found that.
I almost found this. I put my coil like inches from that.
I can pick that up.
I wish you found it.
Bobby, you found your birch scent, so what are you going to find in 2019?
Look at this thing. Is there a toilet anywhere nearby?
Don't even think about it.
Anything?
Your two front teeth?
Just give it the Billy, he'll crack it.
No, don't do that.
All right, Brad.
I don't know. I don't have a
job with better hours so you can dig more.
Yeah, me too. That's great. What I want.
Nate, yeah. Me? My turn? What do I want to find?
Do you remember what you said? You said you wanted to find 1793 anything last year.
That's what I said.
That is what you said. And you ended up finding a gold coin and a bunch of other amazing things.
Yeah. Anything hammered and shiny would be great. Even if I have to hammer it myself. I want hammered. It's going to be a Cobb or like a Lizzie or something like that.
Out of the U.S. because we're going to England.
Yeah.
Apparently. On the DL.
Yeah. Wow.
Brad and I are. And
sorry, man.
Hopefully we get hammered over there. I'm definitely going to get hammered one way or another while I'm over there.
We know that.
Billy boy.
England, beware.
You wanted a padlock, an old padlock, and a crotal bell. You found your crotal bell.
Still need a padlock.
You still want your padlock. Is that your goal for the year?
That and the two reals.
And the two reals. Billy wants that two reals.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Leo.
Uh-oh. Here we go.
Trying not to knock more things off the table.
Oh.
Any goals for this year?
Let's try this again. To get out more again.
To get out more again. Yeah. Leo's the only one that's still in school and juggling
work, family, everything.
Life.
Yeah.
All right, that's it. We're done.
Yeah.